How to write a horror novel. Number one, become acquainted with the creatures of your own nightmares. As any practiced authors would vouch, the first step to writing is becoming knowledgeable in whatever subject matter that has had the unfortunate luck of encountering you this week. Simply put, you can never know true horror until you've experienced it for yourself. You can't speak of fear until you've let them in. You can't tell tales of being frozen in your head until you yourself have felt all eight claws of the beast in the corner of your eye. Converse with every monster and demon who has taken the good time of their nights to haunt and prowl your dreams. Maybe one night when you wake, a prisoner of your own mind, they'll be closer. Befriend your night terrors before you compose of them. Besides, you wouldn't want them to find out your scribblings as mere strangers. Number two, build tension before action. Patience, and the lack thereof, is the key to making or breaking your horror story. The pace of your weapon is up to you to control, not whatever villains your novel debuts. Tension breeds through suspense. Suspense breeds through fear. Fear breeds through impatience. And impatience is what can break a man. Make your sentences rapid, your stakes high, your senses dull. Your words are knives. They can carve out worlds with their beauty or bring a person to their knees. Use them wisely and sparingly. Number three, give your readers deja vu. Sometimes there is nothing, simply nothing eerier than hearing your soul echo in the link of your novel. Haven't you known these characters? Haven't you heard this tune? Haven't you felt these feelings? Haven't you read this before? Haven't you lived in this moment? Number four, horror requires settings to become characters. When building characters, we will often use words such as round and dynamic in the writing community to place a burden upon the necessity of fleshing your subjects into complexities that resemble real people. An anti-hero is never just an anti-hero. An anti-hero is a hero who's been shaped by years of trauma and broken morals into a creature who feeds off the negative energies of others, while humanizing habits and thoughts that shape their very being. And with horror, you must do the same with your settings. Personify places into beings. Attribute aspects, both physical and surreal, that make the place not a place, but a person. The abandoned house that has sat catty-corner to yours for years can't be just a house. It's the former manor of a wealthy bureaucrat who fell prey to death untimely at one of her many, many lavish parties. Preserved in the remains of cracking wood and humid air that's ripe with the smell of mildew. But I still wouldn't worry of any otherworldly sounds you may or may not hear coming from the said house at night. Number five. Make your monsters humanoid. One of the best pieces of advice that I can give when it comes to sketching the horror part of your horror novel would be that nightmares prosper in the uncanny valley of facial features. The closer you get to human, the deeper the emotional response, the deeper the scandal when your reader comes to realize that it was never human at all. Play around to craft and monstrosities of close but not right. Teeth that are too sharp, eyes that are too pale and sunken, claws that resemble fingers. The Greeks understood what they were doing when they built the myth of gorgons from corpses. Number six, if you still cannot find the creativity within you to design a new breed of evil, Then perhaps you should take a look around you. Humans are the only creatures capable of being truly evil, because we are the only creatures with any concept of moral. When animals kill, they do it of habit. They don't glean that it's right or wrong, they just complete the action. But we do it with the knowledge that it's bad. It's far scarier to look in the mirror with the knowledge that we can become the villains that we seek to demolish than to know that others can. Fear feeds on the unknown, but sometimes becoming aware of the known can be worse. Number 7, kill your darlings. It's not unique advice in the world of an author per se to be told that killing your darlings, your useless side plots and characters that you've become far too attached to, is key to fine-tuning your story to perfection. In a rare chance, however, horror offers an entirely different meaning to the phrase, kill your darlings. The death of a presumably likable subject is one of the darkest and surest ways to invoke unrest amongst both your readers and characters, especially when that subject is a person, a mother, a father, sibling, a child, friend, enemy. All wonderful choices to be ripped from your plot with the icy grasp of death. When was the last time that you heard from your neighbor? Number 8. Put yourself into your stories. Put yourself into your stories, literally. When your characters have minds of their own and your strategies and tales refuse to take hold, sometimes the only approach is the hands-on approach. Place your person in your words and experience the horror for yourself. Scare yourself with the pure mania that can be birthed from your mind until legend forms. Number 9, give your readers deja vu. Sometimes there is nothing eerier than hearing your soul echo in the link of your novel. Haven't you known these characters? Haven't you heard this tune? Haven't you felt these feelings? Haven't you read this before? Haven't you lived this moment? Number 10, always know more than your readers. It's good sense to think far ahead of your spectators when writing, in genre more than crippling, anxious, dreadful horror. It wouldn't be fear if I didn't. Don't write during the night. This tip is perhaps more specific than any my previous. Never, ever write in the night. Terror always feels more real, more solid, more rigid in the dark. Things can sneak up on you. Deadlines, poor grammar, the need for a new cup of coffee, foul play, acute paranoia as the shadows stretch closer. Number 12, always leave your readers in